It takes a certain type of person to be an NBA player. While there's a variety of different personalities, ranging from calm to hot-headed, genius to moron, there's one thing that pretty much all NBA players have in common: confident. Actually, most NBA players have completely insane, over-the-top, delusional amounts of confidence. It's part of what got them there in the first place, and it's what allows them to take the stage and compete at the highest level in front of millions of people. But it's not always easy. Like I said, their confidence can sometimes border on delusional, and NBA players can make really questionable decisions. Flirting with fans in the middle of games is definitely a questionable decision. Keep watching to see what it looks like when your confidence is just too damn high. Here are the craziest examples of NBA players getting caught flirting with fans on live TV. Kobe Bryant. When it comes to flirting, the late great Kobe Bryant was in a league of his own. Something about him just always made women lose their minds. When Bryant first rose to national stardom as an NBA rookie in 1996, he was the youngest player ever. In fact, he was still a minor when he was drafted, and his parents had to co-sign his NBA contract. Only a small handful of players in history have been drafted when they were that young. Bryant was by far the best player and the only Hall of Famer from that small handful. It's weird to think about it this way now, but looking back, Kobe started out like sort of a Justin Bieber of the NBA. He became a full-blown celebrity as a teenager and was instantly seen all over magazine covers, dating R&B singers and Hollywood actresses. In a time when pop stars like Justin Timberlake and Britney Spears were all over TV, Kobe Bryant was right there with them. It's not clear how much Kobe really cared about all this publicity compared to what was actually happening on the basketball court, but one thing that's definitely clear is it made him outrageously popular with young women. And from the very beginning, Kobe had lots of game. For example, when he was just 19 years old, he had an unbelievably flirtatious interview with a supermodel who was more than 10 years older than him. Bryant sat down with Sidney Crawford on NBC for a late-night talk show-style interview where the two discussed the date they apparently went on, the origins of his name, and his various impressive accomplishments. Things got more extreme when Kobe started giving her a little basketball lesson. He tried to teach Cindy how to do a basic crossover dribble, but Cindy was way more interested in asking him insanely flirty questions. Some might have even been questionable for primetime television. At one point, Cindy asked the 19-year-old if he likes to dribble before he shoots.
But wait, do you always dribble before you shoot?
I like to, yeah. Well, but no.
Does he know what he just said? I don't know.
Since the young Kobe was all about basketball and also a child, he didn't pick up on the sexual meaning right away. Crawford almost said, "That's right, I forgot you're a virgin," but she stopped herself and said underage instead. The flirting continued. Crawford asked to play one-on-one against Kobe while wiggling her hips in a very unsubtle way. The police were probably already racing towards the set at this point, but Bryant accepted the challenge. "No hand-checking," he said. "You can't touch me." "Oh, that's no fun," Crawford complained.
"Hey, no hand-checking."
"No what?"
"Hand-checking. You can't put your hands on me."
"Why?" "That's no fun."
This was some of the most aggressive flirting basketball fans have probably ever seen, but it was only the beginning for the young Bryant. Numerous other instances would follow, including the time Kobe went on Fox Business in 2008 to talk about his new signature Nikes. Probably one of the last things he was expecting was to get hit on by the Fox host, but that's exactly what happened. In fact, it happened to an extreme degree. The host, Alexis Glick, simply told Bryant, "Wow, you're such a great guy and so handsome. I'm blushing."
"You're a great guy.
Thank
and
you.
You're so handsome.
Thank you
oh
so
my
much.
Goodness, I'm seriously blushing. Okay."
Moments later, she also told the cameras she was really looking forward to seeing him in the finals. Glick also spontaneously asked Bryant for a quick basketball lesson, echoing his interview with Cindy Crawford a decade earlier. What this had to do with business or with Bryant's new shoes wasn't obvious, but Bryant, always a gentleman, was happy to do it.
"Show me some tips, like here. Like,
well,
what's it all about?
Different ways to follow through.
Yeah.
Growing up, I used to follow through with these two fingers, so I had kind of that follow through."
But if you thought Cindy Crawford or Alexis Glick were too direct with Kobe, you're forgetting about this clip.
"I love Kobe Bryant because I want him to have sex with me. Woo!
Oh my gosh, let's go back."
That's Nicole Richie, one of the more famous TV personalities and actresses in the world, especially at the time of this interview, if you can really call it an interview. It was really just an embarrassing moment for everybody, but it goes to show how truly popular Kobe Bryant was. Dwayne Wade. Nobody should be surprised to see D. Wade on this list. Wade is one of the best NBA players of all time and one of the most clutch players too. The man is dripping with confidence, and for his entire career, he's been extremely popular with women despite the fact that he and Gabrielle Union have been a couple since 2008. Wade doesn't have much of a history of being unfaithful, at least as far as NBA stars go. However, in 2013, he and Union did break up for a brief period of time. During that time, Wade managed not only to hook up with another woman, but get her pregnant as well. Despite this, Wade and Union got back together in December of 2013 and got married the following year. All of this goes to show that, while Wade has ultimately built his life around one woman, he definitely has a tendency to sometimes get, well, distracted. In fact, there was one time in particular when Wade became very distracted during an interview caught on live TV. It was during the year 2017, a year which many people forget, Wade actually spent alongside LeBron James in Cleveland. Cleveland basketball is famous for having hosted one of sports' most attractive reporters, Allie Clifton. During her time working basketball games at the Quicken Loans Arena, she had the attention of a number of different NBA stars, including LeBron himself. LeBron always seemed like Allie's favorite, and in 2018, she followed him to Los Angeles, where she now works at Staples Center. This prompted rumors that the two were somehow involved, and if you're interested, we cover this in more detail in our video called NBA Players Caught Shooting Their Shot. But while Allie was still working in Cleveland, she and Wade obviously crossed paths. There was one moment in particular that really stood out. Wade, sitting shirtless and wearing a gold chain necklace, decided he was going to interview Allie for a change. This is one of the most classic moves you see guys do in the NBA when they're trying to flirt. They grab the mic and start asking the reporter all kinds of not always basketball related questions. And big surprise, Wade did exactly that. He went off with a whole series of flirtatious questions, asking Allie about her upcoming birthday and how she was feeling about it. "What are you doing to celebrate your special day?" he asked.
"Okay, what are you gonna do for your special day?"
Allie was clearly not interested in including Wade in any of her birthday plans, but she did seem pretty charmed. She also told Wade that it would be great if the Cavs would win on her birthday.
"You guys could get a win tonight. That would be the ultimate."
"Gotcha."
Something Wade, brimming with confidence, told her they would absolutely do. Well, we looked it up. On Allie Clifton's 30th birthday, the Cavaliers went to Little Caesars Arena and lost to the Detroit Pistons by more than 10 points. Wade did finish with 18 points and 8 rebounds, but still, he spent Allie Clifton's birthday walking out of Little Caesars Arena a loser. Andre Drummond. Andre Drummond is definitely the least famous player on this list, but his story is one of the most impressive. Plus, Drummond has a unique charm that other NBA players usually don't. When he flirted with a fan, it actually worked. Drummond first came into the league in 2012 as a first-round draft pick. He spent the majority of his career with the team that originally drafted him, the Detroit Pistons. Upon entering the NBA, it didn't take Drummond long to show the world that he has the same ridiculous level of confidence as so many other NBA stars do. During his rookie season, Drummond began posting pictures of Nickelodeon star Jeanette McCurdy on his social media pages and making it known that he wanted a date. When you think of a giant, bearded NBA player soliciting a teen actress from a kid's TV show, it sounds pretty weird. But it turns out, McCurdy is actually a year older than Drummond, and both were in their early 20s at the time. It took a while for McCurdy to even notice, let alone respond, to the onslaught of posts coming from Drummond. But eventually, she did. It took the help of many of her own fans, who, like a swarm of annoying friends, started trying to set her up with Drummond. "We think you'll be great together," they told her. Of course, most of these fans didn't actually know McCurdy personally, but eventually, McCurdy decided to start following Drummond on Twitter. The two got in direct contact and started getting to know each other over the internet. McCurdy says that she searched Drummond's profile, digging way back into his timeline and looking at his oldest posts. Eventually, she decided it was time for a date in person. The couple met in LA over Labor Day weekend. This is going to shock you. But even though hundreds of random people decided they should date each other, and even though McCurdy was obsessively creeping Drummond's old posts without telling them, their relationship didn't work out. McCurdy and Drummond both thought for sure that Twitter could tell them everything they needed to know about each other, but somehow, they were wrong. In the end, it was just another depressing example of shallow internet culture. But the story is unique in that Drummond actually landed a date with the woman of his dreams. That's still pretty cool. Steph Curry. For his entire career, Steph Curry has been exceptionally good at the game of basketball, but in 2016, he was arguably the best player in the world. He also may have been the most famous, winning his second consecutive MVP award and the first unanimous MVP in history, and leading his title-defending Warriors to the best record of all time. The Warriors would ultimately lose in dramatic fashion to Cleveland during the finals, but until then, many people were hyping them up as the greatest team in NBA history, and Steph was the big star. It's no wonder that 2016 was the year Steph got caught on live TV in a flirtatious moment that went viral. Steph was so unbelievably famous at the time, and the moment was so viral that the woman actually became sort of a mini celebrity afterwards. But let's backtrack first. The setting was Game 2 of the NBA Finals at Oracle Arena. The Warriors had pummeled the Cavs by 15 points in Game 1, and in Game 2, they beat them down even harder. Draymond Green actually led the team in scoring with 28 points, which hilariously is close to being his career high. Curry was somewhat underwhelming throughout the series. Later on, after Golden State eventually lost Game 7, critics would say he outright choked. But in Game 2, with the Warriors winning big in front of their home crowd, Steph was king of the world. And apparently, nobody could agree more than Ronnie Rose, an exotic dancer from the Bay Area who had damn near courtside seats that evening. Now, knowing what will and will not go viral is a multi-billion dollar phenomenon. Large corporations pay unbelievable amounts of money trying to predict the next thing that'll break the internet, or better yet, create it themselves. So needless to say, it's a complicated subject. But when you look at the clip that was captured by ESPN cameras, it's not hard for anybody to understand why it went so viral. There are several layers behind it. The first is, obviously, the expression on Ronnie's face and the fact that she and Steph are looking right at each other. It's never possible to know what someone is thinking just by looking at them, but people on the internet sure have some strong ideas. And I know I don't have to tell you what they were thinking, because you're probably thinking it too. But a whole other layer to this moment is the fact that Steph's wife, Aisha, is actually in the stands nearby. Funny enough, Aisha is several rows back behind Ronnie, something people on the internet were quick to point out was kind of a hilarious thing. How is this random woman flirting with Steph right in front of his wife while sitting in better seats than her? The situation is definitely funny, but not everyone took it that way. Steph has never spoken publicly about it, but both Aisha and Ronnie have. Aisha criticized the media for paying so much attention to her and making a big deal out of something that was really nothing. Ronnie, being of course an upstanding citizen full of class and dignity, immediately began doing everything in her power to take advantage of the attention. He started going on talk shows and talking to tabloids, and her Instagram started blowing up. As is often the case with super viral moments, the whole thing got pretty controversial. It's hilarious that anybody thought there was anything to take seriously about it, but that's the internet for you. At the end of the day, it'll go down as a funny moment in basketball history that represents the absolute peak of Warriors basketball when everybody wanted a piece of the action.